In this video, we're going to discuss what a pie graph is and how to construct a pie graph. A pie graph is a circle that displays the percentages of frequencies for each category for a given set of data. It uses slices of a pie to represent this. For instance, let's say you had a shoe company that produced the 5 shoes shown on the screen. Here's a table listing the number of sales or frequencies of each of those shoes for a given month. Frequency is often labeled as F, and we're going to use this later in the video. If we want to construct a pie graph to display the sales data visually, the first thing we need to do is tally up the total number of sales, which equals 166, which is often labeled as N, so N equals 166. The next thing we'll do is find the slices of pie for each of the shoe types. There are 360 degrees in a circle or pie, so we need to convert our data, actually the frequencies of our data, into degrees. The formula to do this is degrees of a pie slice equals F, the frequency, divided by N, the total number of sales, and take that result and multiply it by 360 degrees. So for the sapphire shoe, we have 22 sales. Divide that by the total number of sales N, which is 166, and we get 0.1325. And we take that and multiply it by 360 degrees to get 47.7 degrees, which we can round off to 48 degrees. Next, we'll do the same process for the weekender shoe. So 67 sales for this shoe divided by the total of 166 equals 0.4036. Multiply that by 360 degrees to get 145.296, which we can round off to 145 degrees. And we'll do this for the remaining 3 shoes, as you can see here. Now that we have the degrees for each of the pie slices, we can enter them into the circle. For the sapphire shoe, we have 48 degrees. We know that a right angle is 90 degrees, so we can sketch that into the circle from the center of the circle. And half of 90 degrees is 45 degrees, so 48 is slightly larger than 45. We can draw in our line about here. Next is the weekender shoe, which has a pie slice of 145 degrees. If we extend the line out from our first pie slice all the way across the circle, we know that this is 180 degrees. And half of this is 90 degrees. A line between 180 and 90 will be 135 degrees. So we'll draw in our 145 degree line about here. And we have our second pie slice completed. And 35 degrees for the Roadhog shoe will fit perfectly here because 145 plus 35 is 180. So back up in this section of the circle, 90 degrees minus the 48 degree pie slice leaves 42 degrees here. And we have the Red Raider shoe at 20 degrees, which is a little less than half of 42. So we can sketch that in about here. And 113 degrees for our final shoe type, the surface, will go in here. If you're doing this by hand, as I am in this video, you can use a compass and a protractor. Just be as precise as you can in regards to the sizes of the pie slices. And there are plenty of software programs that will produce exact pie graphs and have plenty of options. The last thing we need to do is label each of the pie slices with the shoe types and the percentages of each shoe type. The formula for calculating the percentage of sales for each of the shoes is percentage equals F over N, or the number of sales of a shoe model, divided by the total number of sales, and take that number and multiply it by 100. So for the sapphire shoe, we have 22 divided by 166, which equals 0.1325, times 100 equals 13.25, which we can round off to 13.3. We would continue this process for the remaining shoes, as you see here in the table, and then put these into the pie graph to finish it off. All right, my friends, hopefully this video helped you out. I do have more videos right there for you. Till next time, I am out of here.